Good morning, students. Today we are going to turn towards the main grammar section of English subject, and it is tense. As you know, tense means the change of verbs, and in the tense there are three types of tenses. Main three types. First is past tense. Second, present tense, and third, future tense. What do you mean by past tense? Past tense means the things till now have happened in the past, and what is going on now is in present tense, and what will happen after this moment, it will be in the future tense. So let's study all these main kinds and its subkinds. As you know, there are four subkinds for each tense. For past tense, simple, continuous, perfect, perfect continuous. Like that, in present also same subkinds are there. Simple, continuous, perfect, and perfect continuous. And in future also there are four subkinds. That is simple, future, then continuous, perfect, and perfect continuous. So all those four subkinds are very important for us, and we must think about these four subkinds regarding that main type. First one, we will think about the past tense. What is the construction of simple past tense? Simple past means we can see that in this tense there is no auxiliary verbs occurred in the affirmative sentence. But sometimes when we want to change that sentence or want to create that sentence into past negative sentence or past interrogative sentence, then we use didn't or did. While negation we use didn't, and while interrogative sentence we use did. So the format or formula or construction of simple past tense is subject plus V2. V2 means verb second form, means past verb, plus object or complement. And the example is, he opened an account. See here, we used opened, main verbs past tense. There is no need to use auxiliary verb in simple past tense. Why? It is simple and affirmative sentence. Why negation you can use didn't, and while interrogative sentence we use did there. But we need not to use auxiliary verbs in simple past tense while it is affirmative sentence. Then next one, past continuous tense. See, past continuous, continuous means what is that is going on. It is not completed. It is just started but not completed. And this is in the past continuous tense. So construction of this tense is subject plus was were plus V4. V4 means V1 plus ing. We join suffix ing to main verb, and it is called a V4. After that, object or complement. And example is, we were listening a song. Next, third tense of past. Past perfect tense. Past perfect means which is completed. And the construction is subject plus had plus V3 plus object or complement. And the example is, she had purchased a doll. Means the action is completed, totally completed. That's why happened and it is happened in the past. So we use had and purchased. So she had purchased a doll is in the past perfect tense. And now the fourth subkind, past perfect continuous tense. Here you can see the both tenses combination, perfect and continuous. Is in some extent it is complete action, but not totally completed. So the formula is, or the structure or the construction of the sentence is like this: yes plus had been plus before plus object or complement. And the example is, they had been visiting the temple. As you can think about this sentence, had been visiting means visit. Some visits had been completed, but till now it is going on. Visiting action is till now going on. It means past perfect continuous tense. And now we will turn towards the present tenses. In present tense, there are also four subkinds like the past one. Simple present tense. In simple present, we can see here subject plus V1 plus S or ES suffix. When the subject is from third person singular, means when the subject is he, she or it, or the name of person or anything which is singular, we join suffix S or ES to main verb. And after that, as usual, object or complement. And the example of simple present tense is given here. He plants the trees. Now the second one, present continuous tense. Present continuous means what is happening now. Subject plus means are plus before, means before means V1 plus ing plus object or complement. And the example, see, there are three auxiliaries, and according to the subject we use these auxiliaries. As you know, for I, only I am is used. For singular subject, is used. And for plural, are is used. So here's example, Sita is doing her work. Sita is a singular. And so auxiliary is used, and verb's fourth form is V1 plus ing is used doing, and her homework is object in this sentence. Now the third tense, present perfect tense, and the construction is subject plus have or has plus V3 plus object or complement. And here also the distribution of auxiliaries are there according to the subject. I, we, you, and they, those subjects we use have or have accompany to those pronouns like I, we, you, and they, and remaining accompanied by has. So the example is, I have helped her. Have is used up. And helped means V3, verb's third form. And now the fourth one, present perfect continuous tense. And the construction is subject plus have been or has been plus before plus object or complement. See here, the process is going on. In some extent it is completed, but till now it is going on, and which is happening in the present, that's why it is present perfect continuous tense. And the example of this present perfect continuous is, Rima has been reading the story. Means Rima has completed her action of reading in some extent, at some extent, but not, she had not completed, she has not completed totally reading process. So these things indicate that
In some extent it is completed, but not totally completed. It is going on till now. That's why present perfect continuous is used for such kind of sentences. And now the third tense, that is future for tense and future tense. First one, that is simple future tense. See, future means what will happen after this moment. And in this future, there are four sub-kinds. First, simple future tense means formula is there, subject plus shall or will plus V1 plus object or complement. And here also distribution of subject is there. When the subject are I and we, it is accompanied by shall. And when the other subject rather than I and we use will there. So the formula of simple future is S plus shall or will plus V1 plus object or complement. Here, example, I shall call you. Second type, future continuous tense. In future continuous tense, subject plus shall be or will be plus before plus object or complement is the formula of future continuous. And here also the distribution, same distribution of auxiliary verbs regarding the subject is there. My friend will be selling toys. Now the third one, future perfect tense, subject plus shall have or will have plus V3 means verb's third form plus object or complement. And now the example we can see here, Ranu will have completed her task. In future, the action is complete. Action will be completed. So, Ranu will have completed her task is in the future perfect tense. And the last tense in future, future perfect continuous tense. In this, we can see the formula or the construction or the structure of sentence is subject plus shall have been or will have been plus before plus object or complement. And the example of this type is I shall have been reaching the spot. In this way, we can distribute the tenses in 12 types, and according to these formulas or these constructions, we can change the sentences or change the tense of sentences. Actually, when we think about the changing tenses, we can see that here the only verbs are changing, not the subject or object or complement. Means whatever the object or subject, it is okay, but we must change the verb in that particular tense or according to the tense. In comparison, when we think about the simple tenses, in simple tenses, in simple past and simple present, we never use auxiliary verbs. But in simple future, we use auxiliaries shall and will. In past continuous, three continuous tenses, in present, in past was where auxiliaries are there, in present amis are there, and in future shall be will be are there. Means only auxiliaries are changing here. In past perfect means perfect tenses, here past perfect had is there, then here have or has is there, present perfect, and in future perfect shall have or will have is there. Verbs third form is each and will be in perfect tenses. So we must think about the change of auxiliary verb only. And in perfect continuous also the same thing happened. See here, had been is there. Auxiliary verb had been is used, and after that before is there. Here also has been is there used, and ving means verbs hope form is there. Means instead of had been, in present has been is there, and in future shall have been is there. Means only auxiliaries are changing, and main verbs of that particular tenses are same. Same change is there. So in continuous before and perfect continuous also before, we must think about those change of main verb. In this way, we can translate any Marathi sentence into English easily. And if you change those sentences easily, then you can speak English very well. It is very easy language. Just we stop here. Thank you very much.